The race for a seat on the U.S. Senate is heating up. The Democratic primary featuring two political heavyweights, Senator Brian Schatz and Representative Colleen Hanabusa. Senator Schatz, you may recall, joined us on Wake Up Today last Friday to share his thoughts. This morning, we welcome Representative Colleen Hanabusa to Wake Up Today. Good morning.
Good morning. Good to see you, Ron.
Well, I know you folks have been canvassing, gosh, everywhere. Mm-hmm. What's been the response from constituents as you folks hear their concerns and just what's ahead for you?
You know, it's an amazing thing. This election is so different from all the others. And the reason is that people are so engaged. And, you know, they say, oh, people aren't interested. That's not true. Mm-hmm. I've never had so many people come up to me in stores. I call it the parking lot barometer than any other election. And people want to talk about this election. Whether it's on Oahu or the neighbor islands, people are so engaged as to who should be the person who succeeds Senator Inouye? And that's what the issue is for many people.
Absolutely, for that race especially. Office of Elections, by the way, told us last week they're seeing about 10,000 more people already ahead of the deadline. So you're right. People are talking about this election season. You know, you and your opponent, Senator Schatz, share many positions, very similar. Mm-hmm. What sets you apart from him? Why, if you could share with the voters, why you and not Senator Schatz?
You know, I tell the voters, one of the things that many of them are stunned by is to learn that we started in politics the same time. Mm-hmm. So we both got elected in 1998, and we've been in public service. So I tell people, you know, when you're looking at this race, look at the record. Look at what we've done from the time we were elected, because it's the same time frame. And then determine, who do you trust? It really comes down to trust, especially in Hawaii. Who do you trust to go to Washington, D.C., and to fight for the Hawaii that you want and you want for your children? That's what it really comes down to. So when you look at what we've done, from the time I got elected, I've chaired major committees in the state legislature, and you know, I ended my career as the first woman president of the Hawaii State Senate, the first woman to head either house in the Hawaii State Legislature, and the first Asian woman nationally. And that's a statement of really my colleagues and how people trust you to get the job done. And when you also look at all the different kinds of issues that have faced Hawaii, and who has the legislature turned to resolve it, like Felix, the whole issue of special needs students, the whole issue with crystal meth, and also when the Hawaii Youth Correctional Facility was in trouble, who is the one that everyone says, okay, you had the special task force? And that's a lot of it. That's what it's all about. It's how we define ourselves, the issues that we've tackled, and what we've been able to do for Hawaii.
Some people will say, though, why take the risk of stepping away from a seat in Congress that you currently hold and give up your seat, really, in the House to take on this challenge?
It is because it's about the people. Mm-hmm. You know, this is the first time the people will have a choice. Up until now, you know, Brian is in the seat, but that's because Governor Abercrombie appointed him. But the people haven't had a say yet. And I believe that it is incumbent upon me, because I want to give people the choice, and because I really do believe that I'm the better qualified person for this position, that I'm putting myself up and letting the people decide. Unless we have choices, there is no election.
You know, in previous forums and public opportunities to hear, you said Senator Schatz was a political survivor. Explain what that meant, you meant by that.
You know, it's a compliment. I think those of us who are in politics, part of our ability to continue to serve people is that, you know, elections, unfortunately, there's a winner and a loser. So it's saying that my drive for public service and to serve people is so great that I'm going to put myself out again. Think about what it takes to keep putting yourself out and putting yourself out before the people. I think that's a very positive trait, mm-hmm, for those of us who are interested in public service and have to do it by way of politics and elections to be. We have to have that kind of a, like, intestinal fortitude.
Absolutely.
The guts to keep going.
All right, I want to continue this conversation. If you don't mind sticking around in the
sure,
next 10 minutes, we'll just explore a little deeper about, you know, what you bring to the table that Senator Schatz may not, and also just hear your thoughts on campaign funding,
okay,
as you head into this really last few days and last, mm-hmm, few weeks of pushing.